very much. We're going to do some music associated with mainly three band leaders, Tito Puente, Mongo Santa Maria, and Cal Jader. It's kind of the golden age of Latin jazz. And the first one is a tune associated with Cal Jader, and it's called Tumbao, which is kind of the means basic. It's like a basic beat, really. So it's appropriate. It starts off with the conga, and I hope you enjoy this. This is Tumbao. Thank you. Thank you very much, Tumbao. That featured on trumpet, Max Morden. Max, well, I'll tell you about the history of the band a little bit, but you can see Max has played quite a bit at NJ Pack, like when these main acts come to New Jersey and they have it on the big stage. Max is always in the trumpet section.
I'll be there for the New Jersey Hall of Fame Awards in the hospital.
Is that right?
Yeah. What, two or three weeks from now? Yeah. I'm writing a bunch of charts for the band.
What date is that?
October 29th. 29th,
yeah. Okay, October
29th. No, you do need one more horn.
And he's the co-leader of the Gramercy Brass Band, which does a lot of stuff at Lincoln Center. Been around for like 30 years, maybe?
40
years.
Oh, yeah. I started when I was five.
And that also featured Leonika on piano.
While he's adjusting the mic, let's see, at the Hall of Fame Awards, we'll be playing with Gloria Gaynor, Lisa Fisher from the Rolling Stones band, Tony Orlando, you guys remember Tony Orlando?
Yeah,
he's going to be doing Ty Hill, so I wrote a chart for that. And, I don't know who else. Yeah, I mean,
can you get me tickets?
Yes. I looked today because I thought, it's in the big, in the Victoria Theater, or Prudential Hall. So I looked today to see, I'm thinking that place holds almost 2,500 people. I'm thinking, well, there can't be that many people coming to see this. And there's only about 25 seats left for this room. And so it's like,
wow. Thank you.
Yeah. So I tell you, I wasn't going to tell you about the history of the band, but I have to, I guess, to announce the next tune. So Willie and I met probably in like 1988, and Willie was already playing with Chico Mendoza, and I was kind of new to the group, and at a certain point we decided to form our own group within Chico Mendoza's, was at William Patterson College, and we formed our own group, first called Cajunto Willie. Remember that, Willie? Cajunto Willie. And you remember that, no? So Nito, and then the Latin Jazz Express, which we were forever until the internet came out, and we realized that there's another Latin Jazz Express that had records out, so we had to change our name to Cubano B, Cubano Bop. Anyway, we played Chico started to use us for his, we were from Chico's band, but then he started to use our band for his recordings and to back up different people that he presented. So often it would be Paquito Di Rivero or Hilton Ruiz or Dave Valentine, people like that, right?
Well,
yeah, recordings and stuff. So we were playing a steady gig in Newark right before NJ Pack was formed at a place called the Robert Treat Hotel. And in the Robert Treat Hotel was a venue called the Top Brass. And we were playing regular gig there. And this goes back to the early 1990s. And so I wrote this tune, and it's called Groovin' at the Top Brass. Thank you very much. That featured the remarkable alto saxophone of Mark Gross.
It's ironic that he calls me remarkable Mark Gross when I had the pleasure of working with the great Jimmy Heath for 20 plus years, and he dubs everybody a nickname, and he would call me remarkable.
See that?
So he kind of knew what he was talking about. Yeah. Sorry, Mr. Heath.
Jimmy Heath, yeah. Mark is a lead alto with the Duke Ellington Orchestra. And lots of great, great, great jazz musicians, but did some, you do some Broadway work, right?
Sure.
Yeah, what was that thing with Winfield?
The last one, After Midnight.
After Midnight.
Yeah. And the last one was Ain't Too Proud.
Ain't Too Proud. And Mark has his own groups and just fantastic. And also did, if you remember, Charlie Parker had he did something with strings, Bird with Strings, and Mark has done his version of that. Mark Gross, the remarkable Mark Gross. Okay, this next one is associated with Mongo Santa Maria. And let me see who's on. Okay, this is also going to feature Max on trumpet and Leonica on piano and Emma Dean Rivera on bongos. Where do you hear this? This is really the sound of the Palladium, you know. This is, I think I'm a little too young for that, but are we too young for that, Willie? I don't know.
I don't want to say right now.
Like, we'll pretend, you know. You were there. Leonica was there. Actually, my wife's father, my wife's celebrating her birthday today. Yeah. The woman with the red scarf. The woman with the red scarf. It's also Pavarotti's birthday, but
I'm not singing.
And her father used to go to the Palladium and see Killer Joe. Everybody ever hear the name Killer Joe? He used to dance there at the Palladium. Anyway.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, so we're gonna do Cuco y Olga. Thank you. Time Emmy Award winning percussionist.
Emmy Dean.
And there was a point when I used to turn on the television, and anytime I saw a live act, Emmy Dean was the percussionist, even with Joey DeFrancesco. I saw that. And was with Dave Valentine. And tell me some of the
LaToya
Jackson. Who's that?
Sting.
Sting? You ever hear of Sting? Yeah. Emma Dean played at our wedding.
That's right.
Yeah.
Wow.
And then I played at his daughter's son's wedding. So we
recently. Yeah,
recently. His children just got married.
Wow.
So and he also he's an inventor, a serious inventor of a lot of percussion instruments, and affiliated with LP and different manufacturers. And if you see that bongo head there, that one that's the blue one, that's can I say what it is? It's an X-ray.
And, it's X-ray paper.
And it makes for these beautifully high pops. The only negative thing about it, and Emmy knows this.
Negative.
The only negative thing is they never break. So you buy him once and you're good for life. So he's got to put a flaw. He's got to put some kind of. He's got to mark it with some kind of little incision that it breaks after a year, so he can keep a business up there. But anyway, Emmy Dean Rivera.
Okay.
So the very next piece in the Latin jazz tradition, you take from the jazz literature, you know, and you incorporate it. So this was an arrangement that I wrote of a John Coltrane composition, and it's going to feature Mark Gross, really feature him like nobody else in the band except for Mark, on John Coltrane's beautiful bolero, we're going to call it a bolero, Naima.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mark Gross. We're going to do another tune associated with Mongo Santa Maria. And this one's called Happy Now. Happy Now. Transcribe what rhythms I was hearing, you know. And then when I became a student at William Patterson, he already had his band. Willie was on congas, Joe Farnsworth was on bongos, Clyde Alford on drum set, Don Hunt on timbales. I can't remember everybody. But there was no room for me, really. There was no room. So I played claves, and I played for a year. And I would look at what Willie's doing, and I would try to figure it out, and try to figure out what the bongos were doing, and try to figure out what everybody was doing. And then one time we had this concert and Joe Farnsworth didn't show up. He was in Washington State, and Chico says, you have to play the bongos, you have to play the concert. Well, I don't know if I should tell this part, but. So I had a cut on my hand, you know, and I played the bongos, and it was, you know, physically very aggressive, you know. And Chico, if you know anything about Chico, he grabs the cowbell from you and he'll break right through the bell, right? And he's like this powerhouse. He broke my bell once, and then they dented the other one. I try to keep my bells around away from him. But anyway, so I started playing this bongos, and before you know it, the cut opened up, and it looked like a horror movie. You know, that was my initiation to bongos. It was blood all over. Anyway, so
I needed one of Emma Dean's things.
Yeah. So anyway, then we formed our group, Conjunto Willie. You know. And we've been playing together ever since. And Chico, like I said, Chico would use us for a lot of his stuff, you know. And then he used us, right? I mean, he used us for the recording. You know, sometimes he would get us a gig at SOB's, and if anybody knows that place in Manhattan, and then he wouldn't show up because it was against his, you know, he's a religious man. So anyway, that's too much information, isn't it? Anyway, we're gonna do. So we're going to do a tune associated, imagine this, with Mongo Santa Maria. I always say that really reminds me of Mongo. His power, the power that he plays reminds me of Mongo. This one is a Wahira. I hope it's a Wahira. Mike is my encyclopedia reference here. So, and Neil Cricket. Neil Cricket. Is it a Wahira, Mike? What do you think?
Okay.
So, Peter, a Wahira?
Okay, we'll call it a Guajira tonight.
Manta la mira.
All right. Oh, that would have been good. You're going to like this one. This one, as Chico says, this is the rice and beans. This is rice and beans, okay? Thank you. Thank you very much. Max, Mark Gross on alto. Kind of unbelievable, isn't it?
Yes.
That's incredible.
Remarkable. This next one is, again, borrowed from the jazz literature of the trumpet player Kenny Dorham. Or Kenny, and Phil Schaff, the historian, said it's Kenny Dorham. People say Kenny Dorham, but it's Kenny Dorham. Anyway, Phil Schaff is no longer with us, so we could say Kenny Dorham if we want. Shouldn't say that, right? I like it. Okay, so this is going to feature Leonika on piano and Willie Miller on congas. And this is called Blue Bossa. But we're not playing bossa nova. We're not going to play Brazilian music. So we'll call this Blue Mambo. Blue Mambo. Thank you.
you very much. William Miller. So this brings us to our very last tune. And I should say that we have an email sign-up sheet if anybody wants to know where we're playing next. We can let you know. It's blind copied, so nobody gets your email. I don't sell it to any agencies or anything like that. So before we do the next tune, you probably noticed that I somehow omitted one person from...
Yes.
Yes. Who is it?
Bass player. Right?
Michael Vinyas. So Michael has played with everybody. He's a... you know, there's a book that I have at home called... I think it's Latin. Bass and drums or something. I can't remember, something Berkeley Press. Anyway, so much for that story. And and it tells all the innovators and people they have to, you know, acknowledge to the history of development of the bass and how it's approached in Latin music. And of course, Michael's mentioned in that book. And he's a bass player for, do you ever hear, he's an actor too, Ruben Blades, or people say Ruben Blades. How do you say it, Ruben Blades or Ruben Blades?
He says both.
He says both. So that's, everybody in this room hears that, right? So if you say Ruben Blades and somebody that's corrects fine. You, it's fine.
Right?
It's fine. Okay. It's fine with Ruben Blades. And he's playing with Dave Valentin, and by the way, so is Emma Dean, and so is me. But the last tune of the night, we have to do this tune. This is, you know what it is.
Yep.
He was the bass player with Tito Puente. Yay. And so, how many times did you play this? Yeah. You probably played this tune a lot, I guess.
Well, let me check the counter.
So we're gonna let Michael set the tempo. He says too many times, okay. So he's gonna set the tempo because he knows it best. Cause, okay, here we go. Everybody knows this. Oye, ¿cómo va?
Hey.
Thank you.
Remarkable Mark Gross. On Congo's Willie Miller. Congo's Italian hero, Emily Rivera. On bass, Michael Vinyas. And on piano, Leonica. And my name is Nick Schumann.